Recorded history is replete with examples of individual and systemic racial bias. It was wrong then, and it's wrong now. Even more troubling is the fact that many Christians don't forsake their bias when they accept Christ and don't even leave their bias outside of the church door. Bias takes place in the church also. James is speaking to the tendency that we have to assess people based upon a superficial basis and to treat them positively or negatively, even for non-spiritual reasons. James begins this lesson by setting down a principle about the isms: racism, classism, favoritism, gender bias. None of these are compatible with Christian faith. This principle is rooted in the character of God, who is, after all, just. Then and now, we give special attention to the wealthy and the successful, thinking that they are blessed by God. Men are not saved on the basis of race or wealth or position, nor on the basis of their good works. Men are saved on the basis of the sacrificial death of Jesus. Since God showed no partiality, favoritism, and prejudice is incompatible with our faith in Jesus. James illustrates, saying, two men enter a church at the same time. One of the two men is wealthy, wearing gold rings and fine clothing, fully blinged out, dressed in a way that it is intended to show his wealth, because he desires to be treated with some level of partiality. The other man is poor. Though unintentional, his clothing is old, filthy, ragged, signaling his poor status. If the rich guest is given a warm welcome and ushered to one of the finest seats in the church, and the poor man is barely tolerated and told to stand off out of the way or to sit at the usher's feet, then the poor, the racially different, the woman with the reputation, the man with the strange tattoo is treated differently. Then we are representing an unbiased God by letting our unintentional or intentional biases cause us to act in an ungodly, prejudiced manner. Note here, in James's example, the poor man is not even given a seat. He's not allowed to sit anywhere, fearing that he might soil the church with his filthy garments. We've been to places where we felt unwelcomed or belonged even to organizations that would not dare invite some others into some of the auxiliaries and functions and duties. Unfortunately, sometimes those organizations are run by Christians. James points out, did not God choose the poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs to the kingdom? Those biases dishonor the poor. Pointing to Jesus, James asserts, when our Lord came to earth, he came to heal the sick and to save the lost. He came to lift up the humble and the needy and to put down the arrogant. In essence, we are all equal in God's sight. Note, James is writing to the diaspora of Jewish Christians spread out all over the world. Their poverty resulted from their generosity and from their institutional persecution and bias by the government at that time. Showing partiality towards the sinful rich and the privileged flies in the face of common sense. The rich and the privileged classes had a history of oppressing and exploiting the poor, using institutional and societal systems to persecute them, and using their power to influence and win the day. Showing partiality towards the rich was to break God's law. The royal law, as James writes it, commands God's people to love their neighbor as themselves. Now, their neighbors include the wealthy and the poor. The "as" word means that we must love our neighbors with the same level of concern and care that we love ourselves. And in addition, we must love all of our neighbors equally at that same level. James insists that we must love each of our neighbors and treat each of our neighbors equally, not one better than the other. Partiality and bias violates the very principle of equal treatment under God's law. To show partiality to the rich and the privileged, and to discriminate against the poor, is to break God's law, according to James, and to break God's law in this one matter is to become a violator of the whole law. These Jews to whom James is writing were no doubt scrupulous in keeping other parts of the law. But James says all this scrupulous keeping is of no value if the law is broken in matters of dealing equally with our neighbors. In this day in which this nation is so divided, we must remember that we too must not make decisions based upon superficial values. That homeless person is just as valuable to God as we are. That's the lesson for this week. Have a great week. Bye.